This is Sushant Kochar, and today in this video I am going to be talking about one of the biggest myths of gaining or losing weight, and that is I can gain weight eating this food or I can lose weight eating this food. So it's like, if I eat this food I'll gain weight, if I eat this food I'll lose weight. This is not true. This is not true. If you eat something, you'll lose weight. If you eat something, you'll gain weight. This is not true. So how do we gain or lose weight? We gain or lose weight by eating more than our... if we eat more than our maintenance calories, if we eat more calories than our maintenance calories, we'll gain weight. If we eat less calories than our maintenance calories, we will lose weight. And that is what I have said over here. So you can gain or lose weight eating this food, and this means any specific food. So you cannot specifically gain or lose weight eating a specific food. So now we know it, and we understand that if we eat lesser than maintenance calories, we lose weight. If we eat more than maintenance calories, we gain weight. And I have talked about what maintenance calories are in my previous video. If in any of my videos you do not understand anything that I'm talking about, go and search my previous videos. You'll most probably end up you will most probably end up getting what you're looking for. Okay, so the biggest culprits of this food which can help you gain or lose weight are green tea. So nowadays you might have heard this name a lot, that people drink green tea to lose weight. So let's say there is a fat guy, he realized that he has gotten a lot of fat on his body, so he'll start drinking green tea 3 times a day, thinking that now he will end up losing fat. That is not exactly true. Green tea in itself is a healthy thing. It has antioxidants, it helps you with your long-term health, and also it is said that it can help you burn 50, 60, 70 or maybe 100 calories per day by its specific effect on the body. But drinking green tea itself will make you lose weight is not true. So if you're eating in a calorie surplus, drinking green tea will not help you lose weight, because you are eating more calories than your maintenance calories. Okay, nuts, almonds, pistachios, walnuts, cashews, they have a lot of fat. If you eat them, you'll get fat. Not true. Yes, they have a lot of fat, that is true, but that does not mean that eating them will make you fat. Eating a lot of fat does not make you fat. Wheat flour. So in the bodybuilding industry you will come across, don't eat wheat while losing fat or gaining muscle, you'll gain fat. Not true. If it is in your regular diet, you should keep it in your regular diet. Don't remove it. Paneer, it is called, I guess, cottage cheese in English. Similar to cottage cheese. Paneer is the name given to it in India. Paneer has a lot of fat, it makes you fat. No, it doesn't. Milk makes you fat. No, it doesn't. Malai is the creamy layer that you get on milk after you burn it and put it there for a few hours. Eating malai will make you gain fat, because it is the fat content of the milk. Not true. Eating more than maintenance calories will make you fat. Eating ghee or butter will make you fat. No, not true. In fact, if one has ghee or butter or malai in their regular diet, they should not just abruptly remove it from their diet. Most of the people who remove it because they think that they'll get fat eating them, do not eat other foods that can make up for that removal, so they might end up harming their bodies. So you should eat them. They do not harm you. They can benefit you in one or another way. Now, as we know that eating a specific food does not make you lose fat, eating lesser than your maintenance calories make you lose weight. So we should just cut the food that we eat in half, or we should just eat less and eat whatever. No. That is what I talked about in my video of crash dieting, that you should not be abruptly eating, start eating whatever, just knowing that you can lose weight by eating less. You should eat lesser than your maintenance calories, keeping in mind that your food should give you adequate amount of nutrition for your daily needs, for the daily needs of your body. So if you just start eating abruptly anything, just making sure that you're eating less and that the foods that you're eating are not meeting the nutritional requirements of your body, then you are harming your body. So no, you should not just abruptly start eating less and whatever. So how can foods help us in weight loss? See, I'm talking about mostly about weight loss, because gaining weight is not a major concern among people right now. It is a concern. So if you're trying to gain weight, you eat more than your maintenance calories, you eat in a caloric surplus, and you try to keep your protein requirements full, and you try to make sure that you get all the vitamins and minerals in your body, the antioxidants for long-term health, and you make sure that you get the fiber for proper bowel movements. But I'm going to be specifically talking about weight loss just for this case. But weight gain or weight loss are both almost the same in terms of what we are going to talk about. So foods can just help in your weight loss. Foods can just help in your weight loss. All foods have different effects on your body. If I'm eating an apple or papaya or grapes, they all have different effects on my body, even if I eat the quantities that are same in calories. So for example, protein. If I eat protein in my diet, that protein takes about 20-35% of the calories to digest itself. So for example, if I ate 100 grams of protein and 1 gram has 4 calories, so I took 400 calories from protein. So it would burn off about 80 to 140 calories just to digest itself. So eating more protein can help you burn more calories, so it can help in the weight loss. So that is how a food high in protein helps you in your weight loss. And protein also keeps you full. And some foods have a lot of nutrition value and very less calories. For example, green vegetables like spinach, kale, mustard leaves, any dark green leafy vegetable. So they have a very less amount of calories, but they have a lot of vitamins and minerals in them. So you get a lot of nutrition in very less calories. For example, 100 grams of spinach has about 23 calories. If you had 200 grams of spinach, then that is about 46 calories. But you get a lot of nutrition in return to that 46 calories. So that is how they help you in losing weight, because when you're losing weight, you're eating lesser and you need to meet your nutrition requirements. And green vegetables help you meet your nutrition requirements by giving you a lot of vitamins and minerals in very less amount of calories. That is how they help you in your weight loss. Now so fiber, if you eat foods with a lot of fiber, fiber keeps you full. So if you're eating already lesser than your maintenance calories, if you're eating less foods, you might end up feeling a lot of hunger. So if you have more food in your more fiber in your food, you'll end up feeling more fuller. You'll end up feeling fuller than usual. So there'll be less chances of you craving So that is how fiber helps you feel full. Now there are some foods who keep you full naturally. For example, nuts, almonds, pistachios, cashews, walnuts. They keep you full naturally. So you'll end up eating lesser of something else if you ate nuts, because you'll feel full after eating nuts. So someone might end up saying that, okay, I had 10 to 12 almonds and they were about 100 calories and this much fiber. Now what I'll do is I'll take 25 grams of sugar and I'll mix it in water and drink, and I'll take some Isabgol. Isabgol, you can find it on any medical shop. It has fiber. It is psyllium husk. So, and I'll drink some Isabgol, one or two spoons with water. Now I got the fiber, I got the calories, I should feel equally full as to 10 to 12 almonds. No, you will not feel equally full. Specific foods have specific effects on the body. So 10 to 12 almonds will make you feel fuller than that combination of sugar and Isabgol. So after knowing all this, what should I do? I should just eat more protein to burn more calories in digesting it, or I should just start eating green leafy vegetables, or I should eat more nuts, or I should eat foods that have more fiber. No. And that knowing all this does not mean that you start worrying about all these things. What you need to do is just see what your lifestyle is, what your regular eating habits are, and try to tweak them a little bit. Make some things, eat some things in a bit lesser amount of quantities, and add some things to the foods that you're eating, and make it around your regular diet, keeping in mind that it meets the requirements of the protein, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, and fiber. Fiber will keep your bowel movements going well, so you will not feel constipated. So basically, the ancestral food that you're eating, just tweak it somewhat to make a diet plan that meets your nutritional requirements of your body on a daily basis, and you can sustain it on a long term. So that is how you should look at it. Just start worrying about all this. So if you know someone who someone like you, most probably you had this doubt in your mind. So if you know someone who has this doubt in their head, share this video with them so that they know that eating a specific food not help with weight gain or weight loss. If you like this video, please like it. If you have any comments or questions, put them in the comment box. If you want to receive notifications for my future videos, turn the notifications on. I'll see you in the next one.